And so I want you to write down, number one, is that Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. Jesus's birth was conceived supernaturally by the Holy Spirit. His birth was natural. He was born naturally, but he was conceived supernaturally by the Holy Spirit. In Matthew chapter 1, verse 18, it says the following. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ were as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with the child of the Holy Spirit. This may sound kind of crazy, but the Holy Spirit was Jesus' biological father. He was his father. The Holy Spirit was the one that gave Jesus that birth. Now, Jesus is not the only one who had Holy Spirit as his father. When you got born again, the Holy Spirit became your father. Because we were born from the Holy Spirit. Amen. First time when we got born, the Bible says that we were born with a sinful nature called flesh. So on your first birthday, the devil has given you a gift and you have opened that gift and been using ever since. It's called the flesh. The flesh is this bad thing within us that wants to do bad. When you get born again, when you get saved, when you give your life to Jesus Christ, when you surrender your evil ways to the Lord, you put your faith in Jesus as your only way and the only salvation, God the Father not only gives you a new heart, not only He writes your name in the book of life, not only He gives you gift of righteousness, not only He gives you adoption, you become His child, but God the Father gives you a gift at that moment called the Holy Spirit. Not when you start speaking in tongues, not when you get your act together, not when you stop cussing, not when you stop smoking, not when you stop sleeping around, but the moment you get saved, in that moment the Holy Spirit comes to live inside of you. Can somebody say amen? And so now we have a problem. As exciting as that is, because we got flesh with our first birth, we got the Holy Spirit with our second birth, we got a conflict inside. Your salvation doesn't solve problems, it creates conflict. Because before it was easy, it was just the flesh. Now we have the flesh and the Holy Spirit. You don't live a holy life because you have the Holy Spirit. You have the Holy Spirit to have a potential for a holy life. But it's yielding to the Holy Spirit that brings holiness. Yielding to the Holy Spirit that brings victories. It explains why many Christians still live defeated lives, even though they are genuinely born again. Because being genuinely born again doesn't give Holy Spirit automatic control. It gives Him a presence inside of you, but it's still your part to yield to the Holy Spirit or to yield to the flesh. The second thing I want us to see is not only Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit, but Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit. Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit. And we see that at his baptism in Matthew chapter 3 verse 16, it says the following, is that when Jesus had been baptized, he came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove, alighting upon him. When Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit, I want you to see this. Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit because he left his home. He went to a meeting where John the Baptist was preaching and doing his thing. Jesus got to that meeting, and at this meeting, Jesus just didn't sit on the back and say, I'm just going to see how it works out. I'm just going to see how John is. I'm going to grade John's ministry. I kind of feel like John is not measuring up to my anointing because John is like not healing people. I don't see demons coming out of people. I don't see resurrections. Lepers are not being cleansed. He's dunking people into water. What is the fire? The fire. I need the fire. Jesus doesn't stand there and judge and criticize and say, hey, Johnny, come over here. I'm not going to leave a 5-star review on your Google ministry page. I feel like you still have a lot of room to grow. Jesus doesn't have that attitude, even though he probably had every reason to do that. Jesus gets to the meeting. John is doing his thing, and Jesus lines up in prayer in the baptism to get baptized into the dirty Jordan River. And John stands and says, Jesus, this is not for you. This is the people who went through growth track. You created growth track. That's not for you, Jesus. Stay away from this. We're getting them baptized to get them prepared for you. You're the main attraction. Jesus, John, I know. I want to like do the obedience part. Get me baptized, John. Just stop the talking. Let's do it. He gets Jesus into water, and everybody's getting baptized. They're putting their nose, closing their nose. But Jesus is different. The Bible says when he was in the water, he was praying. I think Jesus was like, don't worry about the nose. And he's praying there. If there's anybody who did not need to pray, it was Jesus. He is God. He could do just fine without prayer. He's standing there in the water. He shouldn't be there. That's not his thing. And he's praying. And when he's getting out of the water, the Bible says the Holy Spirit fills him. Filling of the Holy Spirit is when you are staying, obeying, and praying. Staying in what God is doing in your church. And then do the obedience part, meaning do what God is asking you to do at this season. See, being filled with Holy Spirit is not some spiritual depth. It's very practical. Jesus gives us the example. It's staying, it's obeying, and it's praying. I want us to look at number three. Jesus was led by the Holy Spirit. So not only he was filled by the Holy Spirit, but he was led by the Holy Spirit. It says in Matthew chapter 4, verse 1. So right after he was filled with the Holy Spirit, it says, and then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. Write this down. Whatever you are filled with, you will be led by. Instead of focusing on being led by the Spirit of God, and kind of like, I'm all for reading books on how to hear God's voice. I'm all for going to seminars on how to hear God's voice. I'm all for that, studying more on how to discern God's voice from other voices. But if you really focus on being filled, it will come so naturally, you will be surprised. You will be able to discern the voice of God from the voices of so many other people. If you are filled with God. Number four. Not only Jesus was filled with Holy Spirit, but Jesus was sustained by the Holy Spirit. I want you to see that Jesus was filled with Holy Spirit. He got into the wilderness. And in the wilderness, we see in Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, when Satan attacks Jesus, Jesus replies back and he says, but he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. I want you to see this. Is it feels like in the wilderness, the Holy Spirit's presence wasn't felt. Anybody who's been in the wilderness, or if you're a seed died in a house, you realize that God leaves. You don't feel the presence in the wilderness. You feel heat, you feel temptation, you feel lost, you feel confused. That's why it's called wilderness. And a lot of times we get discouraged because our high moments with God, where the heaven was open, the Spirit came like a dove, the word was spoken, you're the Son of God. Man, I feel the leading of God to fast, to pray. I feel the leading of God, I'm going to serve. I feel the leading of God, I'm going to sacrifice. Things are going great. And then you hit this season where you don't feel the leading, you don't feel the Spirit, you don't see the signs, you don't see the heavens being open. You just get devil like, ah, rah, 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 rah. And you're like, Holy Spirit? Where are we? What's going on? Did you leave me? Dump me? I mean, what's going on? And the Holy Spirit is silent. What do you do when God stops speaking? What do you do when you stop feeling Him? When you feel like you hit a dry spell? I'm going to share with you. I've been practicing this because as a young person, I hit that so many times. And I found myself panicking, this desperate, screaming to God, sometimes fasting even more, say, God, I want to hear you, not realizing the Holy Spirit hides in the Holy Scriptures in the time of my wilderness. Jesus didn't rely on the experience. He relied on the Scriptures. You don't see Jesus going back to the Jordan and say, hey, Holy Ghost, why didn't you go with me? You don't see Jesus say, Father, where are you? Jesus simply opened his mouth. He said, it is written. And the devil was leaving because the power of the Holy Spirit, the presence of the Holy Spirit in your hardest day, where you don't feel like God is talking back or he is near you, at that moment, the Spirit of the living God might not be found in your favorite Hillsong song or Elevation song or Bethel song. You will find him in your favorite verse. When you no longer feel the Holy Spirit, feed yourself with Holy Scriptures. Amen. When you no longer feel the Spirit, feed yourself with Holy Scriptures until they speak to you, until something snaps.
Hey guys, it's Martin. We want to let you know, if you want to get involved in Hungrygen, we have Growth Track take place every first, second, and third Sunday of every month, and it's at 11:30. There's people who have gifts and talents, and they want to put them to use. And that's a place where you get plugged in. And this is where we make Hungrygen a place where people receive love, care, healing, salvation, and deliverance. So get involved and be part of what God is doing in Hungrygen. We also want to let you know, if you are got saved, and if you never had a chance to get water baptized as an adult, we have an opportunity to do so here at hungrygen. Let your life group member know, and we're going to have an opportunity on the Sunday to get that done. And also in June 28th through 29th, we have a thing called Freedom Weekend, where it's going to be a time where we're going to go deeper into inner healing, forgiveness, the love of God, deliverance, and all those things where we'll be able to get healed from any issues that we have, deliverance from any bondage. That it's more of a like where we go further with God. And during that weekend, you can sign up with us on our website, hungrygen.com, and get more information about that. It's a weekend you don't want to miss. It's a time where you're going to get to know God more and more, that when you serve God, you serve him with a pure heart, with a free spirit, and your life is, will never be the same. So we want to see you there. And now let us put our attention to your life group leader.